Welcome, dear viewers, to Couch Warrior TV on YouTube. I am the Couch Warrior, and you are watching The Passage, a Skyrim SE Let's Play featuring Etienne Jorel, the Altmer Ranger, and Garm. Garm, the loyal hound. And together they make the Hounds of the Reach. Now, I just took a little break there. I decided to break the episode up, and what I did is I fast-traveled to the Lover's Stone, which is just over the hill, to try to break Garm out of her stuckness. We'll let her hang out in the camp here. And that seemed to work. So she was at the Lover's Stone, and then we just jogged back together. And here we are. So it's the same evening, just after the tour I gave you last episode of the camp. To give you a sense for why I picked the spot, I just like it. So I think now we are going to get some rest. First, I'm going to prepare some hides from the day's hunting and traveling. Never a shortage of hides, that's for sure. Okay. Now, I don't think there's anything else I need to make here. Might be kind of interesting to make ourselves a bandana. We haven't done one of those yet. Let's just make one, since we got plenty of linen wraps. Okay, so we have treated all of our hides. Let's have a seat by the fire. Take a load off. And I think at this point, Etienne can allow himself a little relaxation. Okay. Very good. So let's have some dinner. Finish off the last of our soup, some water, some more water, some cheese. Our stores are running a little bit low. We might end up having to go to the crow's nest to replenish food on our way back to the plateau tomorrow morning. All right. Thinking at this point, the man has also been basically wearing a backpack for days, which we have come to rely on that backpack significantly. All right. Let's use our cooking pot. We've got some goat I think we can prepare so that it will travel well. That's about all we need to do there. Then we're going to create item. And we're going to create some rough bedding. Alright. And then we're going to go and put said rough bedding in our overlook spot. As I was saying before, the fact that we have a chest nearby and convenient, that's great, but I don't plan on storing anything in there. We've already got one kind of semi-permanent storage space at the crow's nest, and we have to go back there periodically to check it out to keep it from refreshing, I guess. I would hate to have more than one of those laying around that we have to dote over, so not going to do that, but I suppose it could be a good temporary spot if we wanted to just shed some weight to go hunting or something like that, maybe. All right, so this will make a good overlook spot. The reason I like to set the bedding is because it just gives me the option. I could sleep here or just kind of sit on watch, you know? And he can see out over the valley for the most part. And we've got the cover of these trees here if we need to get down there and shoot at something. So this camp is basically set. And we're using, of course, the larger tent with the extra bedroll. The idea that just makes a nice little bed for Garm. Hey, how you doing? What are you doing here? Doing your own thing? Okay. Cool. Your own thing, dog. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got a lot of work to do, but it's interesting when you think about it. It has only been, I guess, 3 or 4 days, when you think about it, since the death of Madinok. And a lot has happened in that time. We've been very busy. So, it's been very productive. I would say that we've probably reached that point where our window of opportunity, this idea that we're going to have surprise, is probably closed now. After 4 days, I'm sure the word has gotten out to even the farthest reaching Forsworn camps that Madinok and Nepos are dead. And even like the letters we've seen where we've seen letters between Briarheart or Forsworn commanders and matriarchs, and letters between camps, where there seems to be some arguing over who to attack and when to attack, and people accusing other people of being too complacent and sitting back on their laurels and stuff. To me, that gives a pretty good sense that we've created a lot of chaos, and now we've got a bunch of groups of Forsworn all acting independently of one another, which works in our favor. All right, let's get some sleep. I'm gonna do 8 hours. Uh-oh. That sounds disgusting. Maybe we'll stay in today. All right, fine. Rangers gotta operate rain or shine, right? Ugh, that's disgusting. Let's go back inside. All right, well, let's get ourselves geared up. We've got some items here I would love to be able to smelt down and use for other things. By now, I kind of imagine that Etienne probably curses this backpack every time he's got to put it on. He's probably sick and tired of the thing. But it's a reality now. All right. It's a fancy bandana. I'll have to try that on him. That's kind of fun. I don't know. I just like all the crap you can make. It's so amazing. Okay. Let's get geared up. So, what do we got? Hood. Okay, I think one of the things I'm going to do before we set out here is we're going to use the tanning rack to make ourselves an alternate travel cloak out of hide, since we have the materials. Okay. And my reasoning here is that the hide cloak may actually be a better alternative for keeping the rain off. Where was it? Down here? Oh yeah, travel cloak hide. So this might keep the rain off without bringing up our body temperature. If we were in the snow, sure. But the last thing we want is to be out here sweating bullets. Sweating arrows, I mean. Okay, let's extinguish the lights, secure our camp. This tanning rack stays here. That's part of the camp now. Follow me, Garm. So now we are going to head to the crow's nest. We are going to reprovision. And then we're going to make our way to the plateau. Now, the place that we need to go on the plateau is the butte. If you remember, it's that kind of strange-looking tower that's on a rocky outcrop. And there is a pretty direct route to the butte by going through that little village that's in the center of the plateau. We can also take advantage of the smelter there, and we'll try to melt down some of the equipment that we've got here into ingots that we can use to perhaps make some arrows and improve our gear later. All right, so Garm is not going to be able to follow us to the crow's nest. That's just the reality of it. I've tried to see if I could get her here in the past, and it just doesn't work. She can get a certain part of the way and then can't make it the rest. So we will do what we can here quick. Fill the water. Extinguish those lights. Okay, what do we got? We can grab that stew, some bread, some cabbage soup, a cheese wheel we can cut up. That meat pie, I'm guessing, is probably on its last leg, so we're not going to eat that. Couple of potato soup. Couple of red apples. Again, we don't know how long we're going to be operating, so we got to be ready for whatever comes. So I'm just going to take a little bit more than I might take if we knew for sure this was going to be just a day trip. All right. We'll take these venison chops also. Now, let's just have a look. Quickly see if there is... is there anything we can leave here? Okay, I'm going to leave the greatsword, leave this, keeping the elven sword. Keeping the iron in case I can melt it down. The orcish stuff we'll keep. Staves are staying here. They're just too heavy. Steel Dagger of Dismay. We aren't going to be able to smelt that down, so it's staying. Barbarian armor, bracers. Okay, shield stays. Bosmer bracers, I'm a little bit intrigued by those. We might check those out. Fine clothes and shoes are going to stay. We really need to find some place to sell some things too. Got a couple different kinds of hoods, which are interesting. They're both light armor, so I'm keeping them for now. Ranger armor, boots, and hood. We've got a full complement of that stuff, which is kind of cool. All right. Good enough. Hey, Melka, how are you today? Looking lovely as always. We are here simply to wrap with Melka from a roleplay perspective. Etienne is showing her the map that we discovered at the lookout point, trying to ask her what she thinks the black blotches on the map mean. She probably is out of touch with the Forsworn because as we're roleplaying it, she hates them. She cares about her tower, and they took over her tower, took it away from her, so she wants nothing to do with them, but because she's out of touch, she may not have too much more information about their doings than we do currently. Hey, be nice to my dog now, all right? Steel shield. Let's take it in case we can melt her down. All right? So we've had a little discussion with Melka. And as soon as I know what that means from a roleplay perspective, I will let you know. Because I'm still thinking about that. The relationship with Melka is something that I find interesting, and but it's one of those deals where, you know, we just kind of have to sort of roleplay that on the fly, if you will. Does that net me anything by adding troll fat into that? No, it doesn't. If we are going to take some time, I suppose I should put on my alchemy gauntlets, right? That would be stupid not to. Need your alchemy. Hoping we can find some more alchemy gear. That'd be great. Fortify smithing, yes. Blister wart, glowing mushrooms. Yeah. Okay, now the other thing we have is we recently acquired some Spriggan sap, which, if I'm not mistaken, is good for smithing also. It is. There you go. Okay. Damage health. 11 points. We don't gain anything by adding that. Store health. All right, not bad. Melka's little tower here is pretty defensible. I've never investigated whether or not this is a location that'll ever be repopulated by Forsworn, but it'll be interesting to see. Can't help but think that that little prison cage could come in handy for Etienne at some point. I don't know why. Hey dog, you leading the way now? Get over ya. Come on now. Scoot, let's go. Bats. Love the bats. It's kind of a long hike to get all the way down to the road again. Iron? Yes. What do you see, girl? All clear. Take that. Boom. Hit it. We gotta make her swim. Good girl. Alright, back we go, ladies and gentlemen. Now, this is also not a time to rest on our laurels, so we're always interested to see how long it takes the Forsworn to sort of reconstitute themselves when they've suffered a major loss. So, we will proceed with caution, just in case they've come back. Pretty quiet. You can tell the hound has been here. You know, another cool thought I had is with regard to the dog and this whole idea of the hound, of course, obviously, that makes the fact that he's traveling with a beast, a fairly poignant thing. Makes sense. I like the thought that perhaps, you know, the idea that when he's coming that his enemies can hear, you know, the echoes of a dog barking or howling, you know, as it the sound bounces off the walls of the the canyons and the reach and stuff, they can hear that as almost like a premonition to their own death. You know, the hounds are coming. And one of my favorite stories is, you know, the Hound of the Baskervilles, and the whole image of giant, deadly, slathering, vicious hound stalking the moors at night in the fog, you know, and stuff like that. And we see so much of that kind of atmosphere in the Reach that I'm always reminded of that idea when I think about the Hound, and how after everything that we've done to this point, his presence in the Reach might strike fear, or even the idea of his presence might strike fear into those who are doing bad things in this part of the world. So mine isn't safe. I go where I please.
Fine, but there's a whole crypt of Draugr underneath the mine. We're not going in there until the Jarl's men come to clear them out, so I wouldn't go down there.
No, I wasn't planning to.
The Dawn Guard. Vampire
I will, however, pick your nightshade.
I don't know where you're going, but stay out of that mine. It isn't safe.
We've been over this. All right. Where's that smelter? Let's check that out while we're here, see if there's anything we can do here.
We tunneled into an old crypt. We're warning strangers to keep out.
Good policy. Okay, padded fur hood, white, black. We want to keep those both. I don't want them. Barbarian Heroes bracers. Break those down. Wheel of Pain amulet. I could get gold out of that.
Guards are useless. They just stand around waiting for a full regiment to come and help.
We're going to melt down the necklace. Melt down the gold earrings.
You want something from me?
Iron arrows we got to keep. Iron dagger we can melt down.
Yes.
Iron helmets.
You want something from me?
Okay, there's a lot we can recover here. This is good. Barbarian armor. Iron mace. So we can recover leather from the ranger's boots. Ranger's hood. Ranger's armor. Elven sword gives us quicksilver? Why? Alright, fine. Refined moonstone from the Bosmer bracers, which look an awful lot like leather to me, but okay. Okay, the silver necklaces, those are actually necklaces we created, so... steel arrows. Okay, we'll recover the steel from the daggers. And from the steel cuff boots. And a sword. Oh, sure. So we can break down that helmet we saved as well. Okay, so the only reason that I'm not touching that ranger gear is just because I was curious to see what it actually looked like. I don't imagine that it's gonna look better than what we've got, but I want to check it out anyway. So let's just see what it would look like if we, with that stuff, how it appears. It's not a bad look either. You know, for a situation where maybe we're operating in warm weather, I don't mind it. I don't hate it. Not bad. Okay. Cool. Good enough. So let's go back to our regular stuff. How long is it going to take me to do this? Okay. Boots of Major Stamina. Gauntlets of Major Archery. And then we had our sleeved leather armor. I think that is it. Ugh, back to normal. All right. So we recovered quite a bit in terms of materials. All right. So this is what we know. We've got a couple of different paths here at this fork. That path is going to take us to Old Hroldan. We've gone that way before, but up this path, this is going to take us directly to the Butte, and that's our next target. So let's go to the Butte. You know what I want to say, right? I want to say, she's a Butte. Okay. We don't need the travel cloak anymore. It's not raining. It's going to get too hot if we're not careful. All right. Now it's time to be careful because that thing is up here pretty quick. I'm certain of that. Okay, let's get off the trail in case they're monitoring it. Holy balls, it's right there. Oh my gosh. Geez, Skarm, I almost ran right over it. I realize I was so close. Alright. Now, we've got a co-op strategy on this too. Can you hear the hounds coming? Hounds are coming for you. Okay. Sit right here. All right, girl. You wait. This is your spot. This is your attack spot, all right? When I give the signal, you know what to do. Okay, this is some more kind of on the fly operation here. Okay, we're looking for a point where we can ascend without being seen, so we're just gonna have to pick our path carefully here. All right. Okay, is that... can I make that leap? Yes. It's a freaking billy goat. Alright. Come on. Come on, get up there. Get up there. No, don't go down. Down is not acceptable. Oh boy. Apparently down is acceptable. Okay, couldn't make that jump too much. So we're going to have to sort of gingerly go up around. We just need enough height to get onto this grass here. There we go. Now we got to look at our apparel because I'm certain I'm not wearing the right cowl. There we go. All right. Steel arrows damage 6. Oh, stone arrows. Steel arrow. No, stone. Ugh. Holy cow. Is it really that bad? Okay, we are out of orcish arrows. Something's going on here. Am I in trouble here somehow? Oh, moderate hunger and mild thirst. All right. All right. Let's take care of our basic needs. Water. Trail food. Carrot. Some bread. Okay, we're in good shape now, I'm thinking, right? Let's double check. Yeah, we're good. So now, if we go back and look at our weapon damage, we should see steel arrows being a bit more respectable at 9. Yeah. Right. Right, we recognize that sound. There is a matriarch here. Looking for guards. Okay, we can just barely see Garm down there. There we go. Right there. You want to draw that bastard down. Okay, now look at Garm's going to take over. She kicks his ass after we started the fight. Okay. Done deal. You hit her once. Get her, Garm. We're coming. That's it. She's done. Nicely done. Perfectly executed. We couldn't have asked for better. Good dog. And we're stuck not being able to give you any commands again. Quick save. Quick reload. See you on the flip side. All right, girl. Follow me. That was a devastating combination. And I just love it, man. I love figuring out the dynamic of how Garm operates and then formulating a strategy that works to her strengths and mine is amazing. And I'm guessing if we come down here, we're going to see another dead body where she ripped that guy's throat out. He's probably over the edge. Yep, there he is right there. Good dog. Brave, majestic, vicious beast. Perfect combo. All right. This is an interesting outpost because... Well, geographically, it's a really unique spot. I mean, look at the vistas here. But it's a very small group up here. I mean, 3-4 sworn plus 1 matriarch. It seems odd. Makes you wonder why they're up here. What is that? Huh. Must have been a glitch. With the note on top of the book there. That was interesting. Dead skeever. These hag ravens are into some very creepy and unsavory stuff. Look at that. What is the symbolism there? Etienne is in the business of trying to understand the thought processes of his enemies, and this is something that just defies all explanation. I mean, what does it all mean? What's the significance of all of this stuff? He doesn't know that yet, and I'm pretty sure it's probably not just perplexing to him, but somewhat frustrating to not really be able to understand the psychology of what he's dealing with here. And Melka's probably not given up a lot of information in that regard. My guess is she's more than happy to let us help her keep her tower clean, but isn't going to tell us any more than she absolutely has to. At least about the inner workings of Hagraven culture. If you can call it that. Alright. Mission accomplished. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for watching the passage, for spending all of your time so invested in this story and supporting my channel. I will tell you, the growth of the channel over the last 2 months has been extremely gratifying and wonderful to watch, and your support has been absolutely wonderful. I've seen a real resurgence in the channel, and it's great to see. So thank you all so much for your support, and I will see you next time.